Ecotourism in Nuqui and Bahia Solano. A Pacific experience. Twenty-five natural areas around the world host the planet's remaining biological and genetic richness. These areas, known as biodiversity hotspots, are in danger of disappearing due to inappropriate human action. These hotspots that occupy less than 2% of our planet contain 60% of the existing species diversity. Colombia, being a mega diverse country, has three of these hot spots: the Amazon, the tropical Andes, and the biogeographic region of Chocó. This biogeographic region of Chocó runs along the entire Colombian Pacific coast, from the border with Ecuador in the south to the border with Panama up north. It includes the municipalities of Nuqui and Bahía Solano, where the Tribugá and Cupica gulfs are located. The landscape resembles a gigantic blue and green mosaic. The lush tropical rainforest contrasts with the magnificent Pacific Ocean. The largest diversity of species is found in the forest, and along the coast, the greatest variety of ecosystems. This is probably the world's richest region in biodiversity. The coastal and marine ecosystems are determined by strong changes in the sea tides that repeat daily, influencing the natural cycles and the life of its people. In Chocó, the migration of the Agallona reminds us about the abundance and exuberance of the region, but it also makes us think about the fragility and the complexity of this magic place.
Es una zona caracterizada por un nivel muy alto, digamos, en cuanto a riqueza o diversidad de especies de flora y fauna. Un nivel muy alto de endemismos, es decir, de especies que son propias de esta región y no se encuentran en otros lugares. Pero al mismo tiempo es considerado un punto caliente de la biodiversidad, que también quiere decir que mezclada esta gran riqueza también hay un nivel muy alto de extinción y desaparición de especies, que es lo que está preocupando hoy en día y que no ha permitido, digamos, que lleguemos a conocer totalmente lo que tenemos y ya estemos enfrentados al problema de tener que salvar lo que se está acabando.
This region is populated mainly by two ethnic groups that have lived in the territory for many years, the Embera and the Afro-Colombian communities. The Embera live at the riverheads and the black population along the coast. Both groups depend upon natural resources and natural cycles for subsistence. This focus on family subsistence and not economic profit is perhaps the secret to sustainable development. The commercial interest of the nation on the Pacific Coast region began at the end of the 19th century. This region was incorporated into the market economy through booms of natural resource exploitation, such as the seeds of the tagua palm tree, rubber tree latex, furs of wild animals, and timber. These extractive processes had social and environmental impact.
The first person that came to Nuqui, más que todo se ubicaron en el barrio La Virgen. Y a medida que iban llegando, ya la gente iba, se iba ubicando, el pueblo iba creciendo, poco a poco. Fue creciendo, unos venían en busca de tagua, otros en busca del caucho, otros venían porque les gustaba, unos se venían a pasear para irse, ya no regresaban más a su pueblo, sino que se quedaban, la mayoría eran del Baudó.
Another important event that affected traditional subsistence practices was the 1935 agricultural colonizing program aimed at bringing civilization and protecting national frontiers. The mestizos from the Andean region of Colombia generated a primary commercial development.
Mi papá se vino pues atraído por una noticia que llegó a la fábrica cuando estaba trabajando y que salió en los periódicos de esa época, que el gobierno estaba dando alicientes a las personas que se quisieran venir a colonizar y a trabajar tierras acá en el Pacífico.
Other immigrants came here searching for new opportunities. However, They used inappropriate exploitation and production models and used inadequate technologies. Timber extraction is an example of this. Precious woods reach the over-exploitation limit without ever considering the possibility of reforestation. Another harmful activity has been farming, encouraged as a feasible development scheme, even though the wet tropical rainforest has poor soils. One cow can barely feed on 5 hectares of land. 5 hectares of extinct forest, of lost ecosystem diversity, and loss of unknown species. The beauty and tranquility of the region, the infinite natural attractions, and the cultural diversity are the basis for the development of tourism. In addition to being a new way of subsistence, tourism integrates various aspects of the region, biodiversity, history, crafts, gastronomy, local knowledge, fishing, and agricultural production, among others. Slowly but steadily, tourism has become a significant economic activity in the municipalities of Nuqui and Bahia Solano.
Yo fui la primerita que monté el turismo aquí en Nuqui, en esa casita. Entonces ya no me cabía la cosa. Entonces yo compré este terreno aquí y con la ganancia de esa inicié a levantar esta. Y así como, en verdad que sí, venía mucho turismo. Entonces yo rápidamente la construí porque a mí no me faltaba el billetico porque venía el turismo.
Like Jesucita, many other local people have dedicated their lives to tourism. The positive acceptance of this activity even prompted the expansion of Bahía Solano's airport. The number of hostels grew up with the increasing number of people visiting the region. Initially, tourists came here looking for the traditional beach and sun. The dangers of massive tourism became evident. It had already happened in other areas of the country. Ecotourism is now associated with travel plans offering bird and wildlife watching activities or forest trekking. However, true ecotourism involves many other social and environmental aspects that must be taken into account.
Después de 3 años nos damos cuenta que el ecoturismo es una cosa mucho más amplia a través de procesos que se han llevado a nivel de comunidad. Sabemos que el ecoturismo es una empresa muy participativa. Si se habla de ecoturismo, debe participar todos los componentes, el componente humano, se debe tener en cuenta el componente social, se debe tener en cuenta el medio ambiente.
Even though ecotourism is a recent practice, and it is still in a planning and consolidation stage, it represents a great challenge for local people. The challenge of improving their quality of life by using and conserving natural resources, while promoting processes of social organization, environmental education, and cultural affirmation. Among all coastal ecosystems on Earth, some of the most productive are the mangrove swamp forest, which occur on the tidal zone of most low alluvial coast in the humid tropics. Many fish and shrimp species live in the mangrove trees, which serve as nurseries where they reproduce and grow. Mangroves are habitats for other species like birds, crabs, and shellfish, among which stands a mollusk called piangua, an essential ingredient of the local gastronomy.
Mi nombre es Nereo Valencia Mosquera. Soy un miembro del grupo de comida de aquí de Coquí. Y a partir de este momento vamos a hacer un recorrido por el sendero del manglar que dura aproximadamente una hora. En este recorrido vamos a ver diferentes especies de mango, la cual les vamos mostrando más adelante.
Nereo is one of the young members of the group of eco guides from Coquí. This group was created with the aim of preserving Coquí's mangroves. 24 well-trained youngsters became eco-guides and have built trails for the visitors to appreciate and learn about the richness of the mangrove. The group is also a positive activity for young people to establish better relationships with other community members as they work for the future of the region and find a way of living friendly with nature. The women from the Coquí Women's Group also share the concern for community organization, community participation, and the sharing of the benefits created by tourism.
Aquí tenemos el arroz con coco que se acompaña con piangua, cangrejo, y el mechao.
This group of 25 women provide lodging and food services to the few tourists that visit the exotic mangrove sites.
Hoy en día ellos son un pueblo modelo. Anteriormente Coquí prácticamente no aparecía como ni siquiera en el mapa. La gente decía Coquí desaparece porque no hay nada que ir a hacer allá. Ahora ya es diferente. Las otras comunidades ven a Coquí como otro modelo de vida.
In the Chocoan Pacific, water is present everywhere in all its forms. The ocean, estuaries, short and abundant rivers, shallow crystal brooks, impressive falls, low and dense clouds that mysteriously cover the forest with mist, the mixture of torrential rainfall and frequent gentle mist showers make this place the second largest rainfall place in the world. Local people depend upon the richness of rivers and valleys for subsistence. The most important productive activities, subsistence agriculture, timber logging, hunting, and gathering of non-timber forest products, take place along the river. A good example of this is Valle River. The Progressive Valle Association Asproval was organized by high school farmers to promote agricultural production at the Valle River.
Gracias por haber venido.
Estamos en la chacra La Alternativa, que es una parcela donde se ha construido con la intención de practicar algunas cosas lo que tiene que ver con la agricultura.
As a strategy for strengthening both farming and conservation activities, an agroecologic trail has been set up at The Alternative as an ecotourist attraction. As the visitor walks along the trail, he or she can see how agriculture practices are integrated to habitat conservation and environmental education in the region. The trail has various stations. In one of them, the guides compare human life to the cycles of nature.
Sí, dentro de la parada novena que tenemos en el sendero, te mostramos lo que es el tumi. El tumi, pues, es una creencia africana. Entonces, con el tumi lo que hacemos es unirnos, agarrarnos de la mano entre todos y como dejar esa energía negativa que tenemos y coger nueva energía a través del árbol. Hay como más hermandad en esa actividad.
Another interesting initiative is the work carried out by the Ciudad Mutis group in Bahia Solano related to water management issues. Through workshops at schools, its members sensitize the community about the use and conservation of this important hydrographic basin.
El objetivo del grupo Ciudad Mutis entonces es adecuar, eso fue en un principio, adecuar espacios públicos con un atractivo natural con el fin de promover el turismo acá en la localidad. Luego nos dimos cuenta de que adecuar esos sitios implicaba involucrar a la comunidad para que se fuera formando ese sentido de pertenencia dentro de toda la comunidad. Y es así como actualmente entonces estamos adelantando campañas de educación ambiental en escuelas y colegios.
The workshops about the importance of water include a practical experience. The kids visit the educational trail of Quebrada Seca, the water source that supplies the vital liquid to this municipality of about 5,000 people. Natural beauty, and its strategic location near the town make of this trail an eco-tourist attraction and a potential source of income for the group. The Pacific Ocean, the largest and deepest on the planet, is here another host for the biodiversity and exuberance that characterizes this region. Rocky reefs, coral patches, cliff headlands, and underwater deserts border the coast, forming sandy beaches several kilometers long that alternate with cliff rocky shores and short high energy beaches. Beaches are very important shelters for local and migratory birds. They also serve as public waterways that communicate coastal villages. Beaches are also used as productive spaces and for gathering delicious and highly appreciated shellfish, crabs, and many other mollusk and crustaceans. Among crustaceans, we find the kakiri or hermit crab that makes its house in the interior of abandoned shells. The Kakiri Civil Natural Reserve takes its name from these crabs. Kakiri is part of the Colombian Civil Society Natural Reserves Network. It is a private enterprise hoping to reach economic sustainability through ecotourist activities involving also social and environmental principles.
El objetivo fundamental de la reserva es la conservación, entendiendo esa conservación desde la parte civil y como una modalidad nueva, una concepción nueva, la conservación-producción, una conservación que debe estar al servicio de las necesidades de las comunidades locales.
The reserve has an environmental interpretation trail that supports education processes. The theme of the trail is biodiversity. It is intended to foster respect for all life forms.
Los turistas se van muy sensibilizados, les ha gustado mucho el programa, la forma en que manejamos aquí el ecoturismo. Y también se hace de una manera muy personalizada. Aquí el visitante no es el turista tradicional, sino es un amigo. Entonces aprendemos mucho de las cosas de ellos y ellos pues también se van con mensajes muy ricos de aquí.
Every year, from September to December, the Colombian Pacific Coast witnesses one of the most amazing events in nature, the arrival of migratory species. Among these, whales, marine turtles, and birds stand out in number, size, and vulnerability. These amazing creatures travel thousands of kilometers in search of special environmental conditions favoring reproduction. For this purpose, Fundacion Natura created 10 years ago the Septiembre Natural Reserve at the Cuevita Beach and established the Turtle Conservation Project. Researchers and local people watch over the eggs until the small turtles are born and help them find their way into the ocean. The project has helped nearly 120,000 small turtles reach the sea.
Septiembre entonces pasó a ser un centro no solamente de investigación, sino de apoyo a todo el proceso de educación y sensibilización en la región. Y se ha transformado como en un elemento y una herramienta de apoyo al proceso educativo formal y no formal en la zona.
The Septiembre Natural Reserve is also a meeting place for young patrols in charge of watching the beaches during the nesting season and eco guides associated with the reserve. This reserve is regarded as a model for education, research, and natural resource management activities. Crabs, music, and traditional dances are cultural attractions of the Chocoan Pacific Coast that complement the ecotourist activity. Dance groups offer the visitors the opportunity to enjoy the sounds and movements of important expressions of Afro-Colombian culture. Skilled craftsmen transform tagua seeds into beautiful representations of natural environment, which are sold mainly during the tourist season. At El Valle, the women's group produces natural fruit jams from exotic fruits such as borojó and marañón. The Ensenada de Utria National Natural Park is one of the main attractions of the region. Visitors come here from all over the world, drawn by the magic surroundings and the most representative ecosystems of the biogeographic Chocó. The Utria National Park and the Tablas de Daimiel Park of Castilla-La Mancha in Spain are sister protected areas. This partnership association contributes to promote the development of ecotourism in Chocó. Utria is turning into a meeting point for diverse people involved in this activity, as well as for the development of local initiatives. The Ecotourist Hostels Association of the Nuqui and Bahia Solano municipalities was created in 1998 and now gathers 35 members, both native and foreign, as well as institutions that support the process.
Ha sido una satisfacción ver cómo después de varios intentos, los hoteleros por fin estamos asociados, estamos reunidos, tenemos un norte claro, un norte definido, no tenemos discriminaciones, hemos venido trabajando por igual.
Another interest of the association is to participate in the design and preparation of the ecotourism development plans of both municipalities.
Entonces son como ciertas normas o pautas a seguir para que la actividad no sea hecha de una forma desordenada, sino que más bien tenga planificación a mediano y a largo plazo.
Sería la población que iría creciendo ya con una base ambiental de pronto mejor proyectada que como han crecido muchas.
Que la gente encuentre opciones de vida en el uso de los recursos de acá. Opciones de vida que no signifiquen el deterioro de ellos. Que sea un ejercicio en donde todos ganan de una actividad en la cual se sostiene y se sostiene a largo plazo.
Entonces nosotros queremos que nuestra región crezca, pero en otros aspectos, por ejemplo, conservando la selva.
Lo más importante que nosotros creemos para nuestra gente es que se prepare, que se eduque, que se profesionalice.
Que cada una de las personas que invierten en el turismo y de las personas que participamos en la actividad turística seamos capaces de ser responsables, seamos capaces de saber que no tenemos derecho a acabar con lo que tenemos.
All these expectations for consolidating ecotourism still leave many unanswered questions. The threats and risks that ecotourist activities may generate in the area must be further analyzed.
Han llegado muchos foráneos y distintas personas traen unas costumbres, como dice, distintas a las nuestras. Entonces, lo que está pasando es que nuestra niñez ya no quiere lo nuestro, sino que ya quieren es lo que trae el foráneo.
Los jóvenes están saliendo del campo, del monte, del sembrar, para volverse, para desarrollar algún tipo de actividad en la parte turística.
Mire, otro problema que nos preocupa bastante, aparte de que no está en nuestras manos, es que la zona de los daños, que por factores de violencia.
Otro de los impactos sociales negativos es el consumismo. La gente de los pueblos no consumía ante tantas cosas. Tú ahora ves una vitrina llena de enlatados. ¿Sí? Se crearon unas necesidades.
El turismo es una de los impactos que a nivel mundial ha acabado con más sistemas y con más recursos naturales en el mundo. Y en esa medida, esta región es una oportunidad precisamente de construir un modelo de turismo que esté de acuerdo, digamos, con la capacidad de carga que pueda tener la naturaleza aquí.
The ancestral force of these communities in the Pacific Chocó is the energy that motivates these local groups to preserve their traditions and to go on with this process being built jointly, day after day. Ecotourism is taking its first steps in the Bahia Solano and Nuqui municipalities. Any long journey begins with a single step. We have a long way to go. Thank you.
Esto queda montado. Esto no está bien nada.